sure you know how little hardware we're standing on right now, but it's still quite a bit. So yeah, that original $300 or whatever price per region came down from the high hardware cost. I mean, it's cheaper now, so you know, I'm sure the price will continue to come down over time, but the architecture is still designed to completely allocate without releasing it a full machine or CPU at all times. So that's kind of the structural problem we're all fighting with right now on costs here, or I should say you guys are fighting with, is that you still need to completely take down at least, you know, one or more cores of a computer 24 hours a day. So you can't share the computer, you can't idle it or anything like that. So yeah, it's that if a tree falls in the forest and there's nobody there, it falls in Second Life, to put it simply. The challenge with Second Life is that it is an absolute requirement that it continue to run at all times. And you can't turn that off, or you know, that feature hasn't been added. So although I would say that it probably would be it is interesting to note that it would probably be possible to kind of idle and save the state of a machine, you know, so that you could bring a, you know, you could bring a server up for, you know, an hour or something. That'd be pretty cool. I don't think that'd be very hard for Linden to do, but again, it doesn't really fit with the land model that we have here, right? What's fun here is to build your own home, and you probably don't want a home that kind of doesn't exist unless someone's standing there. It's sort of, I don't know, it feels odd to me. Yeah.
Bless you.
My God, I could just stand here all day and enjoy everybody's avatars. It's just so awesome. That's the thing that I'm really struck by standing here this morning, like dicks with your cigar and your afro. That is just so good. I don't know what to say. I got to get my old avatar back, like I said. I gotta get saying one of you guys has gotta build me the original. Philip Linden sent it to me or something. Somebody was asking earlier. Yeah, I don't have the name Linden anymore because I'm not working there, and that was, we were always official about that, and I wanted to be as well. We you know, if you've got the last name Linden, you are employed by the lab. Vulcan support, huh, Mio? I don't know. I doubt it. I'm probably not in Second Life. Although I don't think you'd get that much out of it. I mean, the overall architecture. Well, Vulcan's just the graphics layer, so that's not really going to help much. The challenge, like what we did, yeah, like Michi says, it's not. We're not. This isn't really GPU bound here. The problems are more related to the threading architecture, the networking, and everything else. But that's, you know, that's again, that's one of the reasons we did what we did with high fidelity. We started from the ground up, and you know, the rule was that we had to run at 90 frames per second forever. So it's more or less what we're doing. Well, it certainly works on the desktop. I mean, I guess if you ask different people in high fidelity, they'd probably give you different answers. We're a small company, so you know, we haven't. We definitely designed with enabling the HMD to work well as our first mission. So feature-wise, it is, I think, in some ways less comfortable for you when you're on the desktop. But if, for example, you can't reach out and let's see. Well, there's a few things you can't do, like putting something on your avatar, like I was just describing, going shopping. You do that with your hand controllers. So you know, there are some things that you can't do as easily on the keyboard. Or with the mouse as you can in Second Life. Well, there was also some experimentation. I mean, As you know, the one of the amazing things about Second Life is the most popular viewers aren't even made by Linden, which is incredible. But Control Alt David, if I recall, who's a guy who also does work for us, he built an HMD viewer. Alizarin, I hope I'm saying your name right. Cloud rendering. Yeah, cloud rendering is an option. It's super expensive, though. You got to pay like $10 a month for that, because the cloud rendering chews up a whole machine in the cloud, and you've got to pay for that. So it's a sort of an odd... I've never really believed in it that much, because if you have to pay $10 a month for the rendering, why wouldn't you just get another PC or something? I mean, obviously, that would be cheaper, but I, you know what I mean? That's the thing that bums me out about it, is that cloud rendering is so intensive on the server side that we actually did a cloud rendering project in Second Life, and we got it done. I'm trying to remember which technology we used, but we used one of the existing cloud renderers, and I remember using it. It was super cool, but it was incredibly expensive. We had to pass the price on. I think we never launched it or something, or maybe we did, and it's very... No, this was a few years ago, yeah. It was a beta, like Michi's saying. It used Gaikai, or it used one of the commercial technologies for generalized cloud rendering. It was really cool. I mean, you know, you'd be able to go into a spot like this, and you know, you could all but do it on your cell phone. But the problem was, like I said, you were tearing up a whole, you know, GPU enabled machine. Yeah, Mio, we run high fidelity on Amazon's super ultra mega powerful servers. I think some of Second Life's actually on Amazon servers already. So again, it won't actually make things run faster, because the most of the limitations are related to the way the CPU and the networking card and stuff are used by one CPU, basically, by one region, I should say. So they may be doing it already, but it is probably possible. Probably Second Life is running on Amazon's ultra mega powerful servers, but it's probably just they're taking advantage of that to run many sims on one server, but it won't make one sim have more capacity. Hope you guys can hear me okay. I'm just leaving my Oculus on my head. I don't know. That's really hard to say. I mean, look at how rich the feature set is here. I mean, it's just so beautiful. The graphics are just incredible. Like I say, I could just stand here all day and look at everybody. It's amazing. You know, there's so much good technology that's been built in here to move all of it over. It's hard. I guess one of the challenges with Second Life right now is that this was such an immense investment. I mean, you're looking at... I'm just trying to do the math in my head. Now you're looking at something like maybe $100 million of software investment here. And I think the challenge right now is that how many people are on here concurrent right now? There's 50,000 of us or something. How many people are on Battlefront 2? I mean, I don't even know that number, but it's like 10 million, right? I mean, it's just some crazy number. So I think... Right. Yep. So this is, I guess what I'm saying is, this is an extraordinary experience, obviously.
Welcome. You know, this is London City.
I couldn't be more, you know, biased than anybody else probably in that. But we've still got such a small number of people here. We've got to figure out how to make this experience compelling to a broader set of humans. If we could do that, then we could justify, you know, billions of dollars of investment in the software. But as it is, it's difficult. Yeah, I mean, Michi, I would say game reviewers would call it a failure on the basis. Yeah. Yeah, it is. I mean, it's just heartwarming to come in and, you know, talk to people and hear their stories, and talk about people who got married here, for example, as someone just told me a minute ago. But Michi, like you're saying, I mean, it's a failure by the numbers in terms of how many people are using it. it's an immense success in terms of how they use it, what they do with it. I think some of the game reviewers agree with that too. Yeah, it's a success. As it turns a profit. I'm very proud the company's been operating, you know, profitably for a decade, but it hasn't grown. So the company doesn't have the ability to raise a lot more money or, even advertise a lot more, although I think that wouldn't really help, because I think most people that are interested in being here, you know, have managed to find us. Sure. Yeah, that's fair. I mean, probably the biggest project I think that Linden Labs engaged in by an order of magnitude has been Sansar, though. Smaller projects that you're mentioning, like blocks and whatnot, at least in my day and to the extent that I knew, they were very, very small investments in the company's time compared to this. But Sansar, on the other hand, is a much bigger investment in time.
Well,
yeah, that's fair.
You heard a lot here, didn't you? Because a lot of people kept going on for years and years saying that Second Life 2 is coming. According to Sansar, Second Life 2 as a replacement for Second Life. But it's not really, is it? And it was never intended to
be. Well, it just shows you guys what a large undertaking it is. I mean, yeah, the richness of the feature set we have here would suggest to me that even with the large team working on Sansar, it's going to take quite a bit longer. I mean, we're 50 people at High Fidelity, but we were, you know, smaller earlier, and we've been working for 4 years on our stuff. So, yeah, that's true. That's that classic thing, like Apple with the iPhone 10. You can't make people wait. You know, people will abandon their existing products, you know, waiting for the new ones. I've got to run, you guys, because I have to jump on a call in a few minutes here. Torric,
nice.
Thanks for London
nice
City.
To meet
this
you.
Is, yeah, this is really cool. It's a lot of fun to stand around here.
Yes, nice
yeah.
to see you here.
Yeah, I'll try and come back and hang out. This is a lot of fun. I gotta say thanks to all you guys. I haven't done this in a while, and it's totally fun. And I love just talking and reading the text. I'll come back and indulge in that more later. It's really cool. I want to get more thoughts from you guys about what to do next. Yeah, thanks you guys.
Glad you came back.
Nice to meet you, everybody. All right, you guys, take care. Bye.
Take care, bud.
Bye, Philip. Take care.